that you will know that this person has never been under discipline. You see, they become a law to themselves. But when you are under discipline, you will know when to answer. You will know what time to do things, because Amen. God is on your side. Amen. And number four thing is that we need to cultivate the light fellowship. It's very important, as we have come to know Christ, we need to know the people who surround us. Who are we influencing, or who are influencing us? There are some friends that you need to ask God's grace to get off. Amen. We need to recognize that one of the most powerful influence in our lives is the people who we associate with. These are the most influential people in our life, the people we associate with.
Amen.
Sometimes I look at my list and say, among these people I'm associating with, who are these? Who are they who are influencing me? Are they influencing me for good?
Amen.
Are they influencing me for bad? Are they influencing me to achieve the purposes of God, or they are influencing me to divert? So you need to look into your life and see. And I advocate this, and I say this all the time. You say, look, it's very important that you have somebody in life that you can pick up the phone and call in the midst of things. You know that I'm not only acquainted to this one, but he is my friend, he is my pastor, you answer, you help me. You need to have such people in your life. People you can cry to, you say, look, it's hard, please, help me. And these are the people that will hold you and will hug you. They are not going to judge you. They are going to love you, and they are going to help you. You need such people in life. Because no one can be an island. No.
Amen.
No. All what we are saying and everything that we are talking about, we are reading from scriptures. And we are reading from other people that has influenced our lives. For good, not for bad. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says if we walk in light, we will have fellowship with our fellow believers. Amen.
Amen.
If we walk in the light, we will have fellowship with our fellow believers. 1 John chapter 1 verse 7. And I am aware, the Bible says, on the other hand, we are also all warned in the book of Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33, that evil company collapses good morals. Evil company collapses good morals. You and me can look into our association, we can look into our friends, you would say, that one will lead me astray. That one is not guiding me. That one is not helpful to me. Because evil company collapses good morals. So let's look into our associates. Let's ask the question, who are these? Are they influencing me to be a good person? Number five, be filled with the Holy Spirit. It's very important that you are filled with the Holy Spirit as you continue following the Lord. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18. Paul gives two ways of instruction. The first one is negative. He says, do not be drunk with wine. The second one is positive. Be filled with the Spirit. Do not be drunk with wine, but be filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Most Christians would acknowledge that it is wrong to be drunk. Yes, how many believe it is equally wrong not to be filled with the Holy Spirit? It's equally wrong not to be filled with the Holy Spirit. You may say, do not be drunk, but how often are you being filled with the Holy Spirit? You need to ask the Holy Spirit time and again, so Lord, fill me up again. Mama Changala again loves that song. Fill me up, Lord, fill me up. It's so important that we are being filled with the Holy Spirit so that we do not defy the sinful nature.
Amen.
Amen. When we are filled by the Spirit, then we will It's a continuous thing. You need to be continually being filled with the Holy Spirit. You have to continue praising the Lord.
Amen.
Continue thanking the Father. Being humble, submissive, continue submitting to one another. It's like what the Bible says, seek, ask, and it shall be. Knock, seek, ask. It's a continuous thing. Keep on asking, keep on knocking,
amen.
Keep on seeking.
Hallelujah.
And the Lord will open it. It's a continuous thing. We don't say, oh, I've asked for too long. Last year I was asking, this year I'm asking. No, man, I've had enough. No, it's a continuous thing.
Hallelujah.
There's a story which was given by, I think, David Wickerson, that he was praying for one of his friends who was an alcoholic. Every day he was praying for him. For 10 years. He said, Lord, please touch his life. Lord, change him. Not until he was, this friend of his, he was at the deathbed. That's when he accepts the Lord. And Wickerson was so happy. And says, praise the Lord, my prayers were not in vain. At the death point, the man accepted Christ. So let's keep on praying. Let's keep on seeking the Lord. Let's keep on singing to the Lord. Let's keep, the Bible says, do not be weary in doing good, for in due season you shall reap if you faint not. Amen. So it's keep on doing as unto the Lord, and you will reap a harvest. Amen.
Amen.
So let's make sure that we are being filled with the Holy Spirit at all times.
Hallelujah.
And it's very important, as you have accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, number six is to make sure that you pass through water, baptism of the Holy Spirit. Because it symbolizes that we are dying to Christ and we are being raised with Him. Amen. We are dying from certain things and we are being raised with Christ Jesus. It's so important. As we have accepted our Lord Jesus Christ, make sure that we get baptized. Immersed. I'm talking about being immersed in the water, not the sprinkling. Be baptized like our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Baptism is not an option. It is a must. The only person that we are told who was not baptized is only that man who was on the cross with Jesus.
Amen.
He says, today you are with me in paradise. He's the only one we are told that he was not baptized. Amen. And number seven, the last one is this. Put on the full armor of God. Ephesians chapter 6, 13 to 18. What are these full armors? The belt of truth. The breastplate of righteousness. The shoes of preparation of the gospel of peace. The shield of faith.
Hallelujah.
The helmet of salvation. The sword of the Spirit. The word. The lema, word of God. And in all prayers.
Hallelujah.
So in all these, we need to make sure that we follow these steps as we follow the Lord. Number one, live by the word of God. It's very important that we live by the word of God. We read the scriptures and we understand what God is trying to say to us through the word. And put on the garment of praise at all times. Put on the garment. Even if you feel it or you don't feel it, please sing a song in your own language. And it comes out nicely. In your own language you can sing because you understand better and the Holy Spirit understands you more. Amen. Sing it best into that song. Whenever it could be even in the middle of the night or whenever you are, sing to the Lord. Sing to the Lord, and you see how heaviness will leave you. You see how the spirit of depression, the spirit of heaviness will leave you. Why? Because you are praising the Almighty God, and you begin to declare upon your life. Come under discipline. Come under discipline. Come under the disciple, the discipline of our Lord Jesus Christ. Cultivate the light. It's very important that you know the people that surround you. And be filled with the Holy Spirit at all times.
Amen.
And make sure you pass through the water and put on the full armor of God. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against the spirit in the heavenly realms. Amen.
Amen.
So may the Lord bless us as we face this week and as we continue to walk with Him in Jesus' name. And if you need prayers, that there are areas that you are struggling with, we are here to pray with you and ask the Lord to come and set you free, because God is with us. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Pastor, please. Oh, can I, let's pray for our pastor as she travels tonight. Let's commit her in the hands of the Lord after she